think my resolution is to be on my phone less. Just to, you know, I think automatically when you don't know what to do, you just take your phone out and start looking at it instead of talking to people. So I think I'm going to try to be on my phone less this year.
Get engaged a little more?
Get more engaged. It's old school.
That's actually a very good New Year's resolution for all of us. And if you don't have your resolution by now, I guess you got about 4 hours, Kanji, to figure one out.
That answer from Corey makes him my 2014 Person of the Year, by the way. He's played well enough to win his last three starts, actually allowing just 4 goals on 88 shots. The victory over Pittsburgh was his 12th of the season. The schedule is such before the All-Star break that Corey was saying he expects to play a lot. At the opposite end is Jimmy Howard. He needed just 15 saves to defeat the Devils here on November 7th. Now at the age of 30, the Syracuse native is in the prime of his career. He's got a terrific goals against average of 2.12. Ready to go on this New Year's Eve, Kenny.
Great goaltending matchup. Want to say Happy New Year to all our listeners and the New Jersey Devils fans, as well as you, Steve. And let's hope for an exciting hockey game.
And the Devils want to close it out with a win. Such a positive vibe in the room this morning as we got here at Joe Louis Arena. Jimmy Howard's first touch of the puck, and he shovels this into the corner, collected here by the Red Wings. That pass got by the on-rushing Thomas Tatar. It is icing against Detroit.
There you see, longtime general manager and president Lou Lamoriello, and now, yes, Steve, whatever you want to call him, he leads the charge on the bench as a co-coach along with Adam Oates and Scott Stevens, and they have to feel real good about the way the team played with the emotion against the Pittsburgh Penguins. You always want to get that first win under your belt, regardless how long you've been in the National Hockey League, and I know Lou was real pleased with the effort and the intensity they played with. They're hoping for that against the Red Wings tonight as well.
And the shot by Scott Gomez is saved by Howard. Starting lineups are brought to you by Infiniti Luxury Cars that deliver inspired performance. It's been a long time for the Devils, you saw. Consecutive wins, not since November 11th and 14th have they won back-to-back. This is the fifth crack that they're taking at that in a span of 6 weeks. They feel the time is now.
Steve, you saw the frustration on a lot of the Pittsburgh Penguins stars. Detroit's no different. This is a highly skilled team with star guys. You can't make the game easy for them. So that's what I mean by you have to play intense. You have to finish your checks. That's the way the Devils are going to be successful, as we know, with injuries and maybe not as much skill level as some of these top teams like the Red Wings.
Red Wings play it back to the point, and that shot, Jonathan Erickson, it's gloved by Corey Schneider. Behind the Detroit bench, who else? It's been 10 years now from Mike Babcock. The adjective his players use is intense. Now, he was upset with the loss Monday against the Bruins. He said if his players won't work during the game, they're going to work the next day. And he put them through a pretty hard practice as well, Kenny. It was one player this morning who'll remain nameless who often reminds us that Mike is a psychology major. He knows exactly when to back off at the right time. That's been part of his success for a decade here.
I remember those no puck practices, skates.
Shot from the point, blocked away in front and swept away by the Devils.
You don't see those too often anymore, but you have to give your team a wake-up call every once in a while, and I'm sure Mike Babcock worked them hard like he talked about. He was not pleased the way they performed against the Bruins. And you mentioned emotion, intensity. He didn't feel they had much of that the other night. Expect them to come out hard here against the Devils.
5-2 loss to Boston on Monday. Taken here by Peter Harold for the Devils and worked to center ice. New Jersey gains the zone. Here's Joe Whitney getting a crack with the Devils for a second straight game. Played behind the net. Fourth liners are out here. That means Jordan Tutu and Tim Cestito as well for the Devils. They load the gun for Whitney, and his shot is stopped by Jimmy Howard. Again, controlled by the Devils. Zidlitsky works it across. Here's John Merrill. Gives here to Zidlitsky. Marek Zidlitsky, Cestito. And that pass broken up by Steven Weiss.
Joe Whitney with a great chance to slot in. A nice feed from Jordan Tutu. You know, he had a couple of scraps the other night to lift his team. Whitney almost with his first goal there. Glorious opportunity, and slot Howard with the big save.
Played all of 8 minutes in the NHL last season. He had 5:17 of ice time in his season debut Monday night. Taken here by the Red Wings, Thomas Yurko. Fought off here by the Devils and pinned against the boards. Adam Larson works it ahead. And the Devils come out to center. Mike Sislo, called up from Albany, is part of this unit with the Devils, getting a chance here to play with Mike Camilleri and Travis Zajac. Camilleri turns and sends it back in deep. Taken here by the Red Wings. Detroit comes in third in the Atlantic Division tonight, but they're just 3 points behind the conference leaders, Montreal. Here's Harold making his way, punching into the Detroit end, giving chase, Jaromir Jagr. Danny DeKeyser works it across, and it's controlled here by the Red Wings. Justin Abdelkader darts back the other way. Pinned against the near boards, Dinas Zubris caught up with him. That's a pair of eights battling. Abdelkader took the puck back, and a save by Corey Schneider.
First real test for Corey Schneider early on in the first period. Big save there off Abdelkader coming off the left boards.
Henrik Zetterberg's try is blocked away and taken here at center ice by New Jersey. Jagr sealed off by the captain, Zetterberg. Wearing number 40, Henrik Zetterberg now in his 12th season with the Detroit Red Wings.
Oh, you like to see that from your captain. Seal off the big fella, Jaromir Jagr. Very responsible all over the ice, Zetterberg, not just in the offensive zone.
Shot by Johan Franzen is held by Corey Schneider.
Here's the 2-2 play. Puck's turned over. He feeds Whitney in the high slot, and he gets off a real quick shot, wastes no time. And in fact, it deflected off Sestito, so it would have been his goal. Jimmy Howard, good reaction to fight that puck off. And there you see the Wings' Abdelkader coming in on the left side of Corey Schneider, who had an excellent game against the Pittsburgh Penguins. Goaltending has been real solid for the Devils. Down the stretch, it's been goals, and he got a little goal support last game with three against Pittsburgh.
Been a while since that's happened for Corey Schneider. Picked up here by Zidlitsky to center ice. Funnels it ahead. Steve Bernier is met at the line and taken here by Henrik. John Merrill, who played college hockey not far from here at the University of Michigan, so too did Mike Camilleri, loses control of the puck, taken by Xavier Ouellette for the Red Wings. Now Brendan Smith firing. Going horizontal was Steve Bernier at the attempted block, controlled here by Darren Helm. Here's Helm, tied up by Zidlitsky. Zidlitsky kicks at the loose puck, and it's free here for Bernier.
Zidlitsky, stick tied up, plays a little soccer there. Nifty little skate pass to the winger. Puck out of the Devil's zone.
They do that very well in the Czech Republic. I'm something of an aficionado, Kenny, as it's played here behind
goal. Yes, you are.
Taken by Smith. Opening minutes here at Joe Louis Arena. Glad you've joined us 5 minutes in here on New Year's Eve. Sestito tied up along the near boards by Steven Weiss, taken away by the Devils. Cross ice pass deflects off Sestito. He'll give chase with Jordan Tutu. Sestito hits Danny DeKeyser, but the Wings are able to take this away. Detroit looking not just for a 24th straight trip to the Stanley Cup playoffs, but looking to make a dent when they get there. There were great expectations for this team coming in. The record is 19-9-9. Eric Chalinov plays it to center. Picked up at center ice. Here's Zajac on the move for the Devils. Able to nurse one in deep, and Camilleri giving chase. Bumps with Kyle Quincy and taken away here by Detroit. They funnel it ahead quickly to center ice. Riley Sheahan works it across to the stick of Yurko. Played back to the point. Nicholas Cronwall across for Erickson, and that shot is fired away wide and picked up by Harold.
Harold was just crunched by Thomas Yurko after making that pass. But you got to take a hit sometimes to make a play. That's what Peter Harold did. He was in a vulnerable position, but he did clear the puck out of the zone.
Got a rise out of the crowd here at Joe Louis Arena as Green winds it around the boards to the stick of Harold and played ahead here for Scott Gomez. Here's Gomez weaving his way into the Detroit zone. At the circle, shoots, and it's held by Jimmy Howard, who makes the save and will step aside for the first time in Detroit. No score. Welcome back to Detroit, and it's time now for the Cadillac trivia question. There's Adam Henrik. He is the Devils' leading goal scorer in the calendar year 2014 with 26. Who holds the Devils' record for most goals in a calendar year starting January 1st? Okay. I think this is a great question. I don't think I'm going to get the answer right.
Few guys I'm thinking about, but it could be a lot of different choices here throughout the history of the Devils. There's been some good goal scorers along the way.
Eliáš came back from hepatitis, lit the league on fire that second half of the season. I'm trying to recall what he did the following year and if he followed suit with that. Oh, well, the mental marbles are rolling as Scott Gomez takes this and works it across. Played back to center ice, and Merrill for Zubris. Here's Jágr on the near side, able to poke it away from Henrik Zetterberg, but the Wings are able to gather this up. Justin Abdelkader out of Muskegon, Michigan. And Michigan State dumps in where Merrill is back to collect for New Jersey. Given away by John Merrill, he left the puck behind the net. Aaron Helm has it, plays it in front, shot by Zetterberg, and a big stop made by Corey Schneider.
Well, stick broke behind the net. Zidlitsky's got stuck in the net, and Zetterberg with the great chance there.
Devils dodge a bullet, the Wings stay with it. Zetterberg centering tries, Schneider got a piece of that, and it deflects out the center.
Finally, the Devils, Zidlitsky, he had a forward stick, he gets off the ice as he broke his behind the net, and that gave Datsyuk an opportunity to feed a wide open Zetterberg, and Corey Schneider picked up where he left off against the Penguins and made the big, big save right there.
Datsyuk leaves this for Gustav Nyquist, who steps back on and sends it back in deep. Work back towards the point, but waiting for the puck was Bernier, and he'll lift it across to pick up Tuomo Ruutu streaking down the left side. There's Ouellette trying to tie him up, the player just called up from the AHL for Detroit. Henrique guides it back to the point. Adam Larson with a shot, deflected in front towards Howard, who made the save. Big stop by Howard. The Devils trying to stay with this, but broken up by Helm. Played out to center where Larson controls here for New Jersey.
That shot from Adam Larson was redirected. Didn't miss by much.
Sestito dumps in. Giving chase is Whitney. He collides with Ouellette. Steven Weiss healthy, and that's been a rarity for Detroit. Able to help the Red Wings break out. Now this is Drew Miller going wide on Peter Harold, and a big stop there by Corey Schneider.
Well, there you saw Eric Jelena make a poor decision. Bad read. He pinched when he was flat-footed, and the Red Wings, if not for Jordan Tutu hustling back, would have had a two-on-one.
Whitney knocked down from behind by Quincy, and the puck deflects back towards the Red Wings zone.
And those are the things Eric Jelena has to continue to work on, Steve. He brings that offense. He's played much more physical, intense, and that's a good thing. They want to see that from him, but just reading the play there, where that's a time where you just have to back off. Too risky, too high risk of a play with the Red Wings coming full force.
He and Adam Larson have been paired together these three games since the coaching change. Tatar tied up there by the stick of Zidlitsky. Worked across to the stick of Merrill, and the Devils play it ahead. Here's Sislow backhanding this into the Red Wings end. Jonathan Erickson there with him every step of the way. Won the race to the dot, and it's icing.
Couple of opportunities from both teams there. You see John Merrill with the drop pass, and Zidlitsky's stick gets stuck in the net and breaks, giving Datsyuk the opportunity to feed Zetterberg at the left hash marks, and Corey Schneider stands tall. Here you see nothing fancy. Adam Larson gets the puck back to him. Quick wrist shot deflected wide by Ruutu. Or just, shall I say, redirect, and Howard had to get a piece of it. But good job by Adam Larson. You don't have to take the big windup there. We know shot blocking is so good now in the National Hockey League, and guys getting in the lanes. So he just gets it toward the net, almost scores a goal.
Devils have four of the first seven shots in the hockey game. Off the draw, scramble for the loose puck, and taken here by Camilleri. This is something of a tradition, the Red Wings playing on New Year's Eve. They've done it on mostly a regular basis since the mid-1940s, with very few exceptions, including the last two New Year's Eves. The reason for that, the lockout 2 years ago, and getting ready for the Winter Classic last year. Obviously, you wouldn't play on New Year's Eve. Worked across and taken here by the Devils, ahead for Dinah Zubris. Here's Zubra skating it ahead. Picks up Jágr, tries it for the one-timer, and it's blocked away by Cronwall. Jágr able to collect again, controlling here for the Devils. Jaromír Jágr, the game winner last time around. They get it to Larson, and a shot that's fired wide. Came off the backboard and got by Jager's stick. Chopped out here by Andy Green, and a stoppage in play as it's knocked down with a high stick. We'll step aside at Joe Louis Arena. Midway through the first, we're scoreless. Well, the numbers are slightly down for Jaromir Jagr from a year ago, but he had the game winner on Monday. And here in Detroit, Mike Babcock called him the modern-day Gordie Howe. Now, Jagr turns 43 in February. Gordie Howe was playing in his final season as a Red Wing. He scored 23 goals and assisted on 29 others. And then he played 6 years in the WHA after that, including four 30-goal seasons, last played professionally at the age of 51. And that's why we always think Jagr is tongue-in-cheek when he says, I'll play till I'm 50. Don't be so sure what the motive is here.
With all due respect, the speed of the game we all know, and even the greats of yesteryear will tell you that much more difficult in this era, but Jagr continues to impress, and it's all because of his training regime, his conditioning, and yes, the size, strength, and reach. But remarkable, Gordie Howe. I mean, nobody's going to play till they're 51. And he played with his sons in the WHA, which had to be a great thrill for him. I don't think we'll be seeing that again.
Only five other coaches had to worry about Gordie Howe when he was in his prime. Taken here by the Devils and collected back by the Red Wings. Here's Abdelkader working it across. Zetterberg on a backhander goes behind the net with it. Centering try gets back to the point. They dish it back. DeKaiser able to pass off. Red Wings still staying with this. Zetterberg again at the side of the net. Disrupted by the Devils, but we've got a penalty coming up. It's a hold against New Jersey.
Saw the Detroit Red Wings top line moving that puck around, making it difficult on New Jersey. Devils stayed real tight in front of Corey Schneider. You see three guys right in the picture there. The two forwards also come down to help out, but there we're going to see a hold, and Devils will go off right here. Just a little tug on Cronwell, who's jumping past Jagr from his defensive position to try to get into the play, into the mix to get a pass. So the Devils go on the penalty kill here. It's been terrific, Steve, ever since it started very slowly the first 20-25 games. But boy, has it been good the last dozen or so.
No team in the NHL has more power play goals than the Red Wings. They've scored 34 times with the man advantage. Top-ranked unit in the league, 24.3%. Off the faceoff, though, they bobble it out to center, and Nyquist plays this across. Thomas Tatar for Steven Weiss, and the Red Wings now set up as they get it here to Tatar. Jaromir Jagr for holding at 11:15. Worked across to the stick of Nyquist. He can't control. Beautiful play by Sestito to get it away.
You saw that penalty all happen, Steve, because the Red Wings are the type of team that they change positions so well. Probably the best team in the league at it with the skill guys they have, and they just interchange spots and able to move the puck, keeping the Devils out of position. They had to take a hold.
DeKaiser plays it across, now on the stick of Nyquist. His pass bobbled out of midair, and there's Tatar trying to baseball bat it away. He whiffed, but Detroit able to settle it down anyway. DeKaiser at the point, his wrist shot deflected away to the stick of Tatar, who continues to hold the zone for Detroit. The dangerous Nyquist at the circle shoots, and he fired it wide. Tatar bothered by Zajac. Continuing on the kill with Sestito. Loose in front. That's Riley Sheahan. Put it on his forehand, but he couldn't pull the trigger. Collected by Nyquist again. 45 seconds to go in the penalty to Jagr. Gustav Nyquist back to the point. Here's DeKaiser to the top of the umbrella. Able to work it across. Tatar shoots, and that's deflected away, and it caroms out of the zone.
Tatar had that far side. Head up, rifles that puck. Just missed, but puck, it ends up going out of the Devil's zone.
They had so much pressure now. Only 20 seconds left for Datsyuk and Zetterberg to try to do something on the power play. Here's the captain of the Red Wings now, punching it back to the point. Zetterberg gets it back. Throws it in front. Collected by Zubras and skated away by Mike Sislaw. Here's Sislaw. Back with the Devils today. Throws it in front. Howard will hold on with just 3 seconds to go in the kill.
Smart play by Mike Sislaw. Getting that puck on net and getting the faceoff in the Red Wing zone to kill the rest of this penalty. There's Travis Zajac. You talked about three guys the Devils need in the opening. Zajac, Jagr, and Adam Henrique, they all scored. And Travis, we know he's such a good two-way player, but he has to feel a little bit better about finally scoring, because they're going to need him to put the puck in the back of the net if they're going to get string some wins together here. And Travis had a real good game against the Penguins, and he hopes he can continue to get offensive chances.
Quick shot from the circle, trickles wide of the net. Loose and taken here in the corner. Welcome those of you on this New Year's Eve who've watched the Islanders defeat the Winnipeg Jets. As we're now live on MSG Plus, glad you've joined us for this hockey doubleheader of sorts tonight. Here, we're scoreless with 6:15 to go, the third and final meeting of the season between the Devils and the Detroit Red Wings. First Red Wings power play resulted in a couple of chances, but no goal. And we're about to see another. There's a hooking penalty coming up. And is this Jágr again?
This is Jágr again in the neutral zone. This was kind of inadvertent, you're going to watch here. You see Jágr not happy to go to the box here. Looked more like a high stick. Oh, there it is right there. He did get his stick up a little, but Brendan Smith sold it. And we know you just can't use that loose hand or, in fact, get your stick under the arm of a player in tight. The refs will call it every time. And Jágr back to the box. Dangerous time for the Devils. They just did a good job killing the last one. They got another 2 minutes here against the deadly Red Wings team.
Here's Datsyuk with a shot that's deflected away. This time the power play begins with Zetterberg and Datsyuk as the Devils get it out to center. Jaromír Jágr for hooking, 13:56. There were officially no shots on that first Red Wings power play that concluded a moment ago. Here's Zetterberg at center. He works it across. Datsyuk throws it to the side of the net. Collected here by the Red Wings and played back to Cronwall at the point. Coming off the boards with it, Johan Franzen, and he's had big moments against the Devils this season. Played back to the point. Cronwall got rid of it. Bouncing puck got over the stick of Franzen. Now taken by Zetterberg in the corner. They play it back for Cronwall at the point. To the opposite side. Franzen, the redirection from Datsyuk missed, and that puck deflects out of play. Faceoff will come outside the zone. Congratulations to Dynas Zubrus. This is his 1,200th NHL game. 511 of those as a Devil. Now, he signed as a free agent July 3rd, 2007, 2 days after Scott Gomez left New Jersey to sign with the Rangers. And he's lasted long enough, Dynas, to see the prodigal son come back, and now he's his teammate.
I played against Dynas Zubrus. That tells you how long he's been in the National Hockey League. But he's had himself a real good, solid career. Anybody that plays 1,200 games, you're doing something right.
In a galaxy far, far away, he was a first-round pick of the Flyers. 15th overall back in the late 90s. Here's Tatar setting up for Detroit. 45 seconds to go on the Red Wings power play. DeKeyser now at the point. Gives here to Nyquist and gets it back. Pass deflects off the stick of Nyquist. Got rid of it in time. Now Steven Weiss works it across. The quick shot is fired away and taken by the Wings again. Worked back to the point. Here's DeKeyser again. Able to give it up. Tatar to the circle. And that pass again gets by Gustav Nyquist. Nyquist able to come back with it. Drops it back to the point. DeKeyser plays it to the circle. Red Wings patiently. Sheahan played it in front. That pass got by everyone, and it's cleared by Travis Ajak.
Well, these guys could really handle the puck. That's the Detroit Red Wings. But the Devils, again, forcing a lot of passes to bounce over sticks, frustrating the Wings a little bit, trying those fancy passes and back pass plays.
Helm with a shot that's fought off by Schneider. Good start to the hockey game for Corey Schneider. He's gotten the first six that Detroit's gone at him. Taken here by the Devils as we're back to 5-on-5. Zydlitzky works it ahead. Giving chase here is Sislo. Mike Sislo tracks it down and guides it back to the point. Zhelinov firing away. That's off a body in front and controlled by Erickson. Red Wings work it ahead. Here's Helm at center ice. Didn't get far with it. Ruutu able to draw the puck loose and send it back in deep. Devils collecting their first win since the coaching change. Monday versus Pittsburgh. A game Lou Lamoriello described as total commitment to each other. Looking to have it again tonight. Datsyuk, beautiful play to guide it back towards the point. Ouellette got rid of it. Datsyuk throws the puck in front. It's loose in front of Corey Schneider and swept away. The magic of Pavel Datsyuk, and now Zetterberg takes. Throws into the high slot. The return pass for Zetterberg. Looking to get it back for Datsyuk, but it comes back out to center.
We looked at the Devils kill back-to-back penalties. in a short period of time. And what that does, Steve, is gives the Red Wings momentum, even though Devils did a real good job defensively, not giving them many real good opportunities. You see the Detroit Red Wings really starting to hem the Devils in their zone. They've got to get it back, get the flow going back toward the Red Wings end.
Loose behind the Detroit net and taken here by Brendan Smith. 25-year-old defenseman works it ahead, and now Yurko on the move. Fanned on the wrist shot, but follows through here. Adam Larson trying to tie him up. Red Wings now with more pressure as it's taken here by Tatar. Tries to make a move around Merrill and continues to hold. Guides it back to the point. Here's Cronwall firing off the backboard. It's loose in front of Schneider, collected by the Red Wings again. Under 2 minutes to go in the opening period. We're scoreless. Here's Erickson. Taking the long route, goes the wraparound attempt. Schneider there to stop him, and the Devils send this the length of the ice. Icing with 1:42 to go in the first.
Here's the Red Wings on the power play. There you see the puck bounce, but that's because Zubrus was in good position, forcing that pass to hop over the stick. But there's the good shot by Tatar. Corey Schneider gets his left shoulder on that and makes the save. And then Erickson, the defenseman, moving in, trying the quick wraparound. And again, Schneider hugs that left post. He's been real good again so far in this period.
Nyquist on the puck here for Detroit. Able to guide it back to the point. DeKeyser with a shot, blocked away by John Merrill, and punched back out to center. So a lot of the Devils fans were expecting to see Martin Havlat perhaps back in the lineup. He's on the trip. He is missing his fourth straight game due to illness. It is not the mumps, we're told. Shot is stopped by Schneider. It's loose in his equipment, and Corey Schneider is able to gather it up enough to stop play. 1:14 to go. New Year's Eve in Detroit. We're scoreless in the first period.
Stay with us for the GMC Intermission Report. We will chat with Dinas Zubrus right outside the Devils' dressing room, playing in his 1,200th game, out there for the penalty kill at times. What's been better about the Devils' penalty kill? We'll ask him. It's the GMC Intermission Report, plus, guys, the plays of the month to finish out the month of December.
Well, the New Year's wish is that a couple of the plays we see tonight supersede those other plays of the month. Couple of hours left in 2014. Are you a resolutions guy?
I always have a few things that I'd like to change, I guess. I don't know if that's a resolution or not, Steve. Whether I stick to them is another thing.
I was going to say, keep doing what you're doing.
I guess a lot of people can say that.
Henrikken Zetterberg to the left of Corey Schneider. Off the draw, it's taken by the Devils. Here's Green sending this on goal. That negates the icing, and it's taken here by DeKeyser for Detroit.
As this period winds down, been a pretty good one for the Devils, although the Red Wings the last 5 minutes have taken over a lot because the Devils had to kill two penalties, and also players don't get on the ice that don't kill the penalties, Steve, so it makes it so much more difficult to get into a flow and a rhythm. You saw the Devils spend some time in the wings end early, rolling their lines over. But the penalty killers had four consecutive minutes there, and some guys sitting on the bench. Makes it tough to get your legs going again.
Devils' penalty kill has been so good. It's risen in a short amount of time from 30th to 23rd in the league, and they've killed two more to start this game tonight. Here's Camilleri guiding it back. Larson across from Merrill. John Merrill, wrist shot, played it off the backboard. Camilleri trying to get it behind goal for Bernier, but taken away by the Red Wings. And Zetterberg now at center. Wings looking for a last opportunity. That shot sticked aside by Corey Schneider. Punched into the corner with 5 seconds to go. Sislo looks to muscle it out of the zone, and that'll do it for the opening period. No score, the Devils and Red Wings. The GMC first intermission report coming your way in a moment.
No goals that period. The Red Wings turn the puck over. Jordan Tutu feeds Whitney. Tim Sestito just directs that wide, and there's Justin Abdelkader off the boards. Corey Schneider gives him nothing to look at, makes the save. Little miscommunication on the reverse from Merrill to Zdlitsky. He breaks the stick, Datsyuk out to Zetterberg, and Corey Schneider shuts the door. Then Adam Larson with the quick wrist shot from the point. Tipped by Ruutu. Howard makes the save. Red Wings on the power play. Moving the puck around, that's Weiss to Tatar. And Kojic now is there again. And then finally, the mule, big Johan Franzen, coming off the wing with a quick shot, but nothing there to shoot at as Schneider comes out to the top of the crease and makes the save.
What's new on the injury front? It always seems as if it's something, doesn't it? Jacob Josephson and Steven Gionta were placed on injured reserve by the Devils yesterday. Josephson, it's an illness, eligible to play Tuesday against Buffalo. Steven Gionta is out indefinitely with a broken hand suffered in the last game. Lou Lamoriello was saying it's a guy who kills penalties, and they're going to miss his speed as well, Dano. The injury taking place Monday.
Steven Gionta, we talked about being one of the only Ironmen left for the Devils. But here, just hits him in the wrong spot. It's a quick wrist shot from Letang. You see right here, not overly hard, but I think it deflected off Bernier and caught him in the wrong spot. And Gionta is going to be missed. I mean, he sacrifices his body, blocks so many shots there. Unfortunately, ends up doing harm to his hand, breaks his hand, and Steven Gionta, a guy that plays through a lot of injuries, cannot play through this one, and somebody else is going to get an opportunity to play a little more.
That's a chilly Lou Lamoriello on the bench at Joe Louis Arena. There are eight Devils players now on injured reserve. Steven Gionta was the last one. You use that phrase, Iron Man. There's not a single forward now that's played in every game this season. The new year just hours away. Devils start the second with the Zajac line, and tonight that means Mike Camilleri and Mike Sislo. Riley Sheahan, the underrated 23-year-old center for Detroit, out to start this period. It's taken away by the Red Wings and comes back where Andy Green whiffed a chance to clear it away. Yurko trying to find the handle, and now Sislo on the far side for the Devils. Shots on goal for the game. Eight in the first period for Detroit, four for New Jersey.
A lot of those on the second power play the Red Wings had in succession against the Devils. And they took the game away in the latter part of that first period.
Jaromir Jagr, only player on the score sheet in that opening period. A pair of penalties. Backhand try at the side of the net by Yurko is stopped by Schneider. Played back towards the point and controlled again by Detroit. Shoveled back in by Jonathan Erickson. Andy Green on the puck here for New Jersey.
Going back to Steven Gionta and his injury, when you're a guy that pays the price and does all the dirty work and blocks a lot of shots and is first into the corners, digging out pucks, you're at a higher risk for injury, Steven. It's amazing that he's played every game up until he broke his hand last game. But it just, and boy, these guys can shoot the puck nowadays, and Gionta never one to shy away from doing all the little things it takes to win hockey games. And unfortunately, that one will keep him out for a while, the shot from Letang.
All those things you're talking about have kept him in the lineup really since the eve of the 2012 playoffs. He played that last game of the regular season and then stuck. Bouncing puck, Smith with Jagr bearing down on him, just made the safe play and threw it into the Red Wings bench.
Adam Larson, Eric Jelena. There you see Adam. And these two guys are playing together, Steven. What that tells me is Scotty Stevens knows they're both young. They're both in the same situation. They want to become fixtures on the Devils' blue line, regulars in the lineup every night. Adam Larson played over 8 minutes in that first period. A lot of penalty kill time. But it shows me that Scotty Stevens has trust in these two, playing them together and saying, we got to rely on each other. We're both in a situation that we're trying to become everyday NHL players, guys that the Devils can count on in the future. Put them together. I think sometimes that's a good thing. Some people say, oh boy, don't put them together. They're both guys, you know, that have been in and out of the lineup. But I think it makes them focus and want to excel together and help each other out.
That shot is gloved. Peter Harold into the mid of Jimmy Howard for another stoppage in play.
I also like it because Adam Larson is more of a stay-at-home defensive guy, even though I think eventually he's going to become a little more of an offensive player, but he's a smart, sound, positional player. Eric Jelena has to read off that and take some risks, use his offensive ability. Both guys played, Adam, just over 17 minutes against Pittsburgh. Eric a little less, but that will continue to grow if they continue to get better together.
Shot by Larson is blocked away. We've got a penalty coming up. It's a hook, And we'll see the Devils go on the power play. For the first time tonight, Jonathan Erickson is heading off.
He's not happy about the call going to the bench. I was never happy about a call. I always told the refs every time I got a cross check or a rough, I said, that is 2 minutes for being too strong. That's not a penalty. And there you see Erickson saying, I had my stick up, Jaromir Jagr grabbed it and pulled it out of my hand. That's not a hook, but Devils go on the power play nonetheless.
You were misunderstood how many times in your career? What's taken here by the Devils' first power play opportunity? Zubras back to the point. They get it to the circle. Howard tries to throw it in front. Blocked away, but gathered up here by Zajac. Devils' first power play of the night. It's ninth ranked in the National Hockey League. 1-for-3 in that last win over Pittsburgh. Cavallari had it taken away. Hammered the length of the ice by Darren Helm.
And Cavallari tried a sharp cutback and Darren Helm stayed there, didn't bite. Able to poke that puck away and get it down the ice.
Here's Zubras over the line here for the Devils. Met by Miller and cleared again by the Red Wings. Uneventful first 40 seconds here of the Devils' power play. Special teams so good for the Red Wings this season. We talked about the number one power play. Penalty kill is ranked second in the league. Kept alive by Zdlitsky, or so we thought.
That was a little offside. Puck crossed the blue line, and Merrick tried to sell it and keep it in. But the referee saw he was unable to do that.
Gomez will continue on the power play with Bernier and Jagr. Zdlitsky and Jelena are the point men here. Jonathan Erickson taking the first Detroit penalty tonight. A hook at 2:16. Off the draw, collected by DeKaiser, who sends it the length of the ice again.
I shall say the linesmen saw, but we call them referees too, right?
Structures. They're all guilty, right?
They're all guilty.
Taken here by Jelena and fired in. Brad Meyer and Gord Dwyer are the referees. They do a wonderful job. So do the linesmen, Brisbois and Galloway. Controlled here by the Devils and taken by Zdlitsky. Over the stick of Jagr, and now Gomez. Back to Jagr, who works on the half wall. Plays catch with Gomez. Jagr again. Takes it and works it across. Here's Jelena at the circle. That shot blocked away by Jimmy Howard. Collected by the wings and cleared away.
Good pass through the seam. Middle of the ice in the Detroit zone by Jaromir Jagr to Erik Jelena. He had some time. Got quite a bit on that wrist shot. Jimmy Howard makes the save.
Gomez puts the brakes on. Plays it across. Jelena drops it back. Here's Zdlitsky firing, and he rang it off the post. Marek Zdlitsky with the Devils' best chance of the night.
Good puck movement again. He can really wire it, can't he, Steve? We've seen Marek Zdlitsky either score or hit the post on a few occasions this season.
Back to 5-on-5. That's an impressive kill by Detroit as Zetterberg collects here and gives to Datsyuk. Works his way around Route 2 and gets only as far as the circle where Green winds it around, but it's kept in the zone. Here's Smith at the point for Detroit. Played off the backboard. Larson keeps the puck moving, and Route 2 works it across. Abdelkader, though, will track this down for Detroit. Opening 5 minutes of the second period. Still scoreless at the Joe in Detroit. Datsyuk battling with Andy Green in the corner. Able to jar it loose. Sislo trying to find the handle. Somehow comes back to Datsyuk. Taken by the Devils and lifted away. DeKaiser back. This is icing against New Jersey.
Devils come close to opening the scoring in this game. You see Jelena back to Marek Zdlitsky. He gets it away quick. And see if Howard, no, he didn't even get a piece, but that was directly off the post, the outside of the post, and goes wide. But you love the way he gets that puck, and there's no hesitation. The quick windup gets it off. And if it's not that time he happened to stop a little bit, Steve. It's a one-timer, but he was obviously pass coming from the left side, not in one-time position.
Timeout here is called in the opening minutes of the period.
Devils were tired there, and I think, is it in fact the Devils call the timeout, Steve?
We are hearing at the scorer's table it is. The last we got from the scorer's table is that it was Detroit that called the timeout, although that would be somewhat breaking with the situation.
Well, my mistake. I was assuming because the Devils had some time in their end, they iced the puck and have to have the same five guys in there. So that surprises me, my mistake.
Not the first time we've seen it, if it did happen, but off the draw. Off the draw, it's taken here by the Red Wings. Mike Babcock maybe trying to settle his troops down and do something with the faceoff in the offensive zone. Taken here by Franzen. Here's Johan Franzen. Tried to work it back in deep. Collected instead by New Jersey. And Ruutu darts back the other way. Tuomo Ruutu works it across. They work it down low. And that connection just missed with Sislo heading for the net. Off the feed from Henrik. Thrown back to the point, but this will go all the way back into the New Jersey end. John Merrill takes it off the backboard and works it ahead. At center ice, here's Joe Whitney, all 5'6" of him, the leading scorer for the A-Devils at the time of his call-up earlier this week. Outlet pass by Quincy, barely got out of the zone. Bouncing puck collected here by Detroit. 2-2 delivers a hit on Nyquist, and it's taken here by Adam Larson. Picked up by 2-2 and worked ahead. Sestito. One hands it into the Detroit end. Following up again, Tim Sestito, and he's leveled. The tail end of his shift, he went down in front of the bench. Worked across, now Yurko on the move for Detroit. Tomas Yurko sends it in deep. Green waiting for it. Zubras put it behind his own net, taken here by Yurko. Red Wings still trying to make something of this. Tomas Yurko, the Slovakian, with Sheahan. Near goal, collected instead by Harold, but a penalty coming up as he grabbed the puck. It's a hook, and it's against the Devils. We'll set up the Detroit power play when we come back.
You see another hook here by the Devils. Dinis Zubras, stick in the midsection. We always say it, they call it every time, and there you see a little too much. Stick in the midsection of Sheahan, and Zubras off for a hooking. Detroit goes back on the power play. The Devils now two hooks and a hold, and that's something that they're going to have to rectify in this game if they want to win.
Don't want to go to the well too often against this particular power play. As we mentioned, it's number one in the league. Off the draw, Devils want it back. Andy Green tried to swipe it out of the zone. Red Wings all over the puck, and now the battle in the corner. Detroit power play coming into this chance 0-for-2 with a total of just one shot. But Datsyuk guides it back. Here's Cronwall on the puck. Datsyuk again. His wrist shot blocked away in front by Andy Green. Collected by Cronwall, and another block in front. Adam Larson got in the way of that. There's Zetterberg at the side of the net. Taken off his stick. Comes free to Sestito, who sends it the length of the ice.
Great work by Larson and Green. Both jumping into the corner. Could be risky at times, but the puck's loose there. It's bouncing. They pounce on the Red Wings. Don't let them set up and get the clear.
Shorthanded. It's taken away here by Zajac off the stick of Datsyuk, who lost control. Andy Green coming into tonight, third in the National Hockey League in blocked shots with a total of 92 at the start of the game tonight. Only Chris Russell and Roman Josi have more than Andy Green this season. Merrill able to punch that out of the zone. 50 seconds to go in the penalty kill.
You wouldn't think of Andy Green as your typical shot blocking defenseman, but you know why he blocks a lot of shots, Steve? Because he's always in position. Whether it's his stick, his body, there's just not a lot of lanes for these guys to shoot when he's there because he's so sound and he's so mobile as well as a defenseman.
Loose puck taken here by Riley Sheahan for Detroit. Tries to come in front with it. He punched it off the side of the net instead. Collected by Detroit. Here's Sheahan again, guiding it back to the point. Gets it back from DeKaiser. Riley Sheahan works it down low. Return pass from Nyquist, broken up, and at the side of the net. That might have gone off the outside of the post. The Devils clear it away.
Again, good job of the Devils in their end, getting to loose pucks, not letting the Red Wings set up. But back to Andy Green, another thing. He doesn't go down and block shots, Steve. That's what I mean by your typical shot-blocking defenseman. He's just always in the right position.
Puck winds around. Out of the box is Zubras. Another successful kill for New Jersey against an elite power play unit. Zubras works it across. Here's Sestito. The drop for Green. He shoots and he fired it wide. Picked up here by Henrik, and the Devils stay with it. Zubras shovels it free. Now Sestito in the corner. Worked it away from Eriksson. Cycles it for Henrik. He gives to Sestito. Devils trying to answer back with some pressure here after the successful kill. Zubras shakes loose of his man. Henrik guides it back to the point. controlled here by Zydlitsky and played to Andy Green. Across, Zydlitsky trying to lose his man, able to shovel into the corner and collected here by Detroit. The long pass out of the zone is handled by Yurko and he funnels in. Scoreless, and we approach the midway mark of period number two. Glad you've joined us here on MSG Plus tonight as Scott Gomez has it in his own zone. Here's Gomez maneuvering ahead, looking for Camilleri cutting. Instead, it's picked up here by Yager. Two Red Wings draped over him, and Zetterberg took it away. Punches it across, and now the return pass for the captain, Zetterberg. Able to backhand one in front, looking for the redirection with Abdelkader in front, and that just missed. Work back to the point. Smith with a shot, and he rifled it wide. Here's Datsyuk in the corner, comes away with it. Zetterberg shoots. That's blocked away in front. Peter Harrell to the stick of Gomez. It deflects in front. Another chance. Zetterberg tried to feed it to the side of the net, but it's broken up.
A flurry by the Red Wings and Devils, and I think Abdelkader actually blocked that shot from Zetterberg. He was standing in front providing a screen and it hit him in the backside, fortunately for the Devils and goaltender Corey Schneider.
Things opening up a bit here as Helm takes it into the Devils' end. Collected by the wing, Schneider fights off that shot from the sharp angle off the stick of Johan Franzen. And this puck deflects out of play with 9:16 to go in the second. We're scoreless, Corey Schneider and Jimmy Howard tonight.
Devils on the penalty goal. You see Andy Green right here. He's in the front of the net. He's going to leave and go to the corner. But great timing right there. Sometimes you go, oh, no, what's he doing? That's reading off your partner, reading that Zetterberg's back is to him, and he can pounce on the puck. Detroit Red Wings can't get set up. Smart hockey play by Andy Green. I speak from when I played with Scott Stevens and killed penalties for 12 years with him. That's something we always wanted to do. Scotty going for the big hit. I'd be right behind him to pick up a loose puck and clear it, because if you give skilled players time to set up or you hesitate, but you have to time it properly. Andy Green did that to perfection there.
He was playing with Severson until the time of the rookie defenseman's injury. It's Peter Harrell, and that's a relationship that had to be fostered pretty quickly between the two. It's done pretty well the last few games as we see Camilleri work it across. Feed this for Zajac. He got a shot away. Fought off by Jimmy Howard, who made the save.
Quick wrister from Travis Zajac. Scored a goal last game. Maybe he's feeling like he's got to shoot the puck more.
Two-point game for Travis in the win versus Pittsburgh. Taken away here by Ouellette. Gets a shot away and the save made by Schneider, who controls and stops play. This spring, Broadway's biggest spectacular will be at Radio City Music Hall. The New York Spring Spectacular starring the Rockettes, March 12th through May 3rd. Visit Rockettes.com/spring. And if you walk the riverside where we are in Detroit today, you can't wait for spring to get here fast enough. My, was it freezing today on the walk.
It's a bit chilly today, Steve. That is for sure in Detroit. I heard it's cold back in New Jersey as well. I don't think quite as cold as here.
Just the dusting of snow here in Detroit on New Year's Eve. Nothing big. Route 2 works it in front. Bernier trying to find the handle, and he just missed on the shot attempt on Jimmy Howard. Played back to the point, and here's Green for the Devils. Guides it across. Gets it back from Harrell. Andy Green, wrist shot. Off a body in front. Swiping at the loose puck. Bernier, and the follow-up try went wide. Penalty here is coming up. It's a hook. Let's see who the guilty party is here.
It's the Detroit Red Wings. Devils going on the power play. I believe it's Ouellette, the young defenseman for the Detroit Red Wings. Devils getting good position, inside position there. Ruutu gains the line and cuts to the middle. There's Bernier looking for that loose puck. Gets a whack at it. There you see again Adam Henrique. Again, we'll look at that play. Bernier almost gets that from his left skate to his stick. He would have had an open net. But Howard able to make the save. Then Green with the quick shot and Bernier fighting, battling. And there's Adam Henrique on the rebound, and Ouellette dragged him down.
Devils now operate on the power play with Yager on the first wave. He gives to Scott Gomez. Here's Yager down low for Gomez. Centering try, trying to feed the puck for Harrell. Yager trying to turn around and shoot, but knocked off his stick. Collected by Yager again, and the Devils reset. Zydlitsky is the man at the point. Shot by Yager, blocked away. Zydlitsky has it and gives to Harrell. worked across. Jágr nearly lost control. This puck stays in the zone. Harrell trying to hold the zone, but it deflects back.
You got to make quick decisions with the puck against this Red Wing penalty kill. I understand why they're near the top of the league with the way they get on that puck and use their sticks.
Bouncing puck gathered up here by Zydlitzky, looking to punch it back in. Guided back towards the point. Another bouncing puck. Zydlitzky did well, and he gives to Jágr. Played into the corner for Gomez. In tight space, gives here to Jágr. Under a minute to go in the Devils' power play. Jágr behind the net. Works it free. Now Gomez comes off the boards and shoots. He fired it wide. Harrell trying to find the handle. Zajac works it across to the circle. They feed Zydlitzky now at the point. Marek Zydlitzky gives here. Harrell has it. He shoots through traffic. Saved by Howard. The rebound popped up. Settled down by New Jersey. And the puck taken away by Detroit. Back the other way come the Red Wings. Glendening with a shot and a save made by Corey Schneider. Good chance on each end with 20 seconds to go in the Devils' power play. Time for another rush here as it's taken away by Harrell. Helm is all over him.
Real good job by Glendening using his speed. Anticipation, he deflects a pass away from Peter Harrell. Helm. In the Detroit zone and able to go off to the races, gets a shot on Schneider.
Out of the box is Ouellette. We are back to 5-on-5. Power plays producing chances, but no goals for either side. Now Helm dishes off. And the Red Wings back into the attack. DeKeyser hitting the corner. Punched out of the zone here. Ruutu all over his man Zetterberg. And now crashing into the Detroit end where Datsyuk comes back. DeKeyser. 5:40 to go. Second period of a scoreless game. Worked across, controlled by the Devils. Here's Zhelinov, the defenseman, who skates it away. Avoided the hit. Zhelinov still going, and now Sislo works the puck across. Collected here by Ruutu. Played back to the point. That shot by Larson is blocked away. Sislo trying to find the handle. Gather up the loose puck. Battle behind the Red Wings net. Undeterred here is Tuomo Ruutu, but it's taken away by Detroit. They leave it in the zone, though. Ruutu works it across. A little bit of Keystone Cops out there now as it deflects out towards Larson in his own end.
Ruutu was an absolute buzzsaw that shift, taking the man, hopping around guys, controlling the puck. Nothing to show for it, but good pressure by the Devils in the Red Wing zone.
Back the other way for Detroit is Zetterberg, the Wings captain. Able to work it in deep. Puck deflects away. Jordan Tutu able to lift this out of the zone. Knocked down with a high stick. Faceoff will be in the Detroit end when we come back. 4:37 to go in the second. No score.
Both teams have had a lot of power play opportunities, but nobody has broken through yet. It's scoreless, but stay with us at the second intermission. We asked the Devils to give us their favorite moments of 2014, both on the ice and off the ice. So we'll have that coming up. And I know you guys have a trivia question to think about. I don't want to inundate you with questions, but you should give us your favorite moments on and off the ice of 2014.
Okay, I've got two. The look on Chico's face when they gave him a boat. That's the off the ice moment. And maybe the Eliash backhander just very recently as he scored just a wicked goal. It was every highlight package across North America.
Well, now that you mention it, the Chico moment was great.
Quick shot. They score out of nowhere, Dano. The Devils break the ice, and in the middle, it's Joe Whitney. 5'6". You can't see him in the scrum. His first National Hockey League goal.
Well, you couldn't see who scored that goal, and it didn't materialize very quick, but Joe Whitney gets this puck off so quick. It's on his stick. It's off it. There you see him finish the man there, and the Red Wings turn it over. Puck comes right to him. There's three Red Wings around him, and he absolutely rips this puck. Wrist shot over the glove of Howard to give the Devils a 1-0 lead, and what a moment for Joe Whitney. What a shot. Boy, did he get that off his stick quick. And it started because he finished his man. You mentioned he's 5'6". He took the man. You don't have to run him over. But it caused chaos. Detroit turns it over. Puck caroms right to him. And he does the rest, giving the Devils a lead.
He was Albany's leading scorer at the time of his recall. What a great moment for him at the age of 26. and in just his third National Hockey League game.
Well, that was a National Hockey League shot. He absolutely ripped that puck over Howard's shoulder. I don't think Jimmy Howard, not knowing him, a lot of goaltenders study the players they're going to be against, and a lot of times they know the guy, especially with Devils, a lot of veterans. He doesn't know Joe Whitney, and I don't think he knew he could snap that puck like that.
Power move here by Zajac, who gets a shot away, and it's held by Howard.
Take a look one more time there. The puck finds Whitney right there, and he just snaps it. Doesn't waste any time. Watch again. The turnover there. Puck gets right on the front of his stick, and he doesn't hesitate. It was just a quick release. That shows me he has those offensive instincts, has that goal scoring ability, just the way he let that thing go. A lot of guys might have hung on or hesitated a little bit. Yes, he got a break puck coming right to him, but he wasted no time getting it off, Steve.
From Reading, Massachusetts, an undrafted player, he's never going to forget New Year's Eve 2014. Good for him. Here's Jágr now at center. Dishes off for Gomez. Played across, and now Zubras throws it to the side of the net, looking for the redirection, and it comes away to the stick of Zidlitsky. Here's Jágr again. Devils with a surge here after the Whitney goal. Shot by Zidlitsky is fired away wide.
We talked about best moments of 2014. No question that is Whitney's best moment of 2014. His first National Hockey League goal.
Worked ahead and picked up here. I saw Joe Whitney on the exercise bike about an hour before the game started. Sometimes the guys who don't expect to play much, I gather, want the workout on the bike. Little did he know. Quick shot from the far side. It was fought off here by Schneider. He and Stefan Matteau were called up together. Matteau is a healthy scratch again tonight, waiting for his chance. Merrill tries to guide it away to Steve Bernier. So the Red Wings now trying to fight from behind as it's collected here by Nyquist to the stick of Franzen. Johan Franzen with 2:13 to go in the middle period. Henrique there to deal with him. The helmet is knocked off Franzen. Loose at the side of the net. Trying for the wraparound. They score! Darren Helm, what a terrific play. He beat Corey Schneider, and the game is tied.
This happened awfully quick as well. And this is a real good goal by Darren Helm. Boy, I don't know how he wrapped that around so quick. He had to take a couple of strides. And there you see him in front of the net with John Merrill. Nyquist does the dirty work. And look at the wraparound as he's falling down. And it looked like Schneider had it originally. Take a look again. His left pad is there. Oh, I think it went off Steve Bernier's stick trying to help out. He's trying to do his job and help the goaltender. If he doesn't get his stick in the way, Schneider's pad is there, the left pad. But Bernier got a stick and it just deflected up. And that's a tough break for Steve Bernier. And the Devils, of course. But that ties the hockey game up. Give Helm credit as he dove and fell down behind the net. Quick move.
And it comes really against the run of play in that last sequence. Helm the equalizer, and now Tatar over the line. Thomas Tatar with a shot that's deflected away off Greenskate. Loose in front. Red Wings looking for the go-ahead goal, but that got punched aside wide. Deflected puck reaching out for Camilleri, and it's thrown back into the corner by Ouellette. 1-1 game, under a minute and a half to go now. In period number two, Larson checked by Tatar. Crowd coming alive suddenly here at Joe Louis Arena. Shot from the point, deflected, and it went wide of Schneider's cage. This is the 167th consecutive sellout in this building. Bouncing puck at center, off the stick of Camilleri. On the tying goal, it's Helm from Nyquist and Franzen as Zetterberg marches in for the Red Wings. Centering try on the backhand. Picked up here by Camilleri and worked across. Gomez trying to get on the loose puck in the final minute of the period. Hauled down by Erickson, and the Red Wings will break out again. Here's Datsyuk on the puck. Harold and Merrill, the defenseman, dropping back. Gomez there deflects it off his stick and sent back into the wing's end. This will be an icing call against the Devils. 31 seconds to go.
Here's the equalizer by the Detroit Red Wings. See Helm make the quick move around the net. And there you see right there. What a great shot from up above. Great work in the truck, fellas. Steve Bernier reaching out, trying to help Schneider. He's doing everything, desperation, and the puck happens to go off his stick and over Schneider's pad because he had the post, left post hug. But that goal doesn't happen if not for the work of Gustav Nyquist as well, Steve. He was being tugged at, pulled at. He kept his feet churning, able to get that puck to helm, and another good play by him.
Work back to the point. Quincy with a shot that's blocked. And here's Jágr with a dozen seconds to go. Plays it across. Peter Harrell. See if the Devils create a last chance here. Harrell had it taken away from Quincy. Back the other way. Helm. 2 seconds left in the period. Gets a shot away. And Schneider makes the final save of the period. 40 minutes in the books. 1-1 game in Detroit. Second intermission report coming up.
Money, Steve, Mr. Hockey reference. Jágr and Scotty Gomez play a little catch here on the power play. Jágr finds the seam, feeds Jelena with a quick wrist shot. Howard makes the right arm save, and then puck ends up back again on the same power play to Marek Zidlicky. He blasts one off the left post and out, and there's Cicito taking a hit from Ouellette. And now the Devils on the PK. They've been real good against one of the best power plays in the league, blocking shots, getting in the lane, creating havoc for the Detroit Red Wings in the power play. There's a nifty little shift from Travis Sajak and a good shot, save Howard. And here Bernier, soccer style, skate to stick, unable to deposit that puck. Right here, the forecheck from Whitney. Creates a turnover. Cicito tips that puck over to Whitney, and he goes upstairs for his first goal in National Hockey League. What a shot. Waste no time. Quick wrister. But the Red Wings shortly after, Darren Helm with the wraparound ties this hockey game up. And that was weird, Steve, because that was a little bit delayed. It was like the puck was sitting there. A second later, it's in the net. But it went off Steve Bernier's stick over the pad of Corey Schneider.
And that's where we are now, 1-1 hockey game. Here we are, hours away from ringing in 2015. Fans here want to celebrate with a Detroit win. The Devils have other ideas. Stefan Matteau is a healthy scratch. We ran into him just a couple of moments ago. He was reminding us that Cestito and Joe Whitney play a lot together for the Albany Devils. Paul Thompson, for the most part, was the other part of that line. And if you want to feel good for somebody, feel good for 33 tonight. He described him as maybe one of the most likable guys you are going to meet. We've only had brief sessions with him here in the time that he's come up. He's relishing this chance.
Well, it's only fitting that Cestito ends up getting an assist on Joe Whitney's first National Hockey League goal. And I think that's a reason he's in the lineup over Matteau right now. And Stefan Matteau, will get his opportunity. But I think the Devils know they need scoring. They need a guy that can put the puck in net. Joe Whitney showed you he's capable of that with that quick wrist shot.
And here we go. Third period underway, and a big one for both. Taken here, John Merrill battling Riley Sheahan behind the net. It's loose. Sheahan able to gather up again. Now lost control, and it comes here to Mike Sislo, who works it out of the zone. Taken here by DeKeyser back in his own end. Shots on goal for the game, 17-12 in favor of the Red Wings to this point as DeKeyser darts behind his own net. Devils with the line of Gomez, Jágr, and Zubras on here. Puck taken by Datsuk, left it behind him, and now Zetterberg is able to take.
Curious here in the third period what unfolds. We've seen the Red Wings in the past been able to turn it up a notch and find a way to beat the Devils. You saw the Devils have a 4-1 lead in New Jersey.
Loose at the side of the net, and Schneider has to make the save on Zetterberg. Near calamity there for New Jersey, but Schneider is strong. Cadillac bringing you tonight's trivia question. It is answer time, and this has to do with goals in a calendar year. Adam Henrique, the Devils' leader with 26 goals in 2014. Who holds the record for most goals in a calendar year? I'm going to guess Eliash, but that's a shot in the dark.
I'm going to go Brian Gionta. He scored 48 one year.
Snickering back in New Jersey right now and can't wait to see us on Friday, I'm sure.
Boy, Johnny Mac. Yeah, he scored a few goals for this organization. A few big ones.
Collected by Bernier and hammered back in. They miss on the hit on Smith, and Franzen takes this and works it ahead to Darren Helm. The goal scorer for Detroit is over the line. Ouellette backhands one towards goal. That went wide. Here's Smith on the near side for the Red Wings. Brendan Smith maneuvers away from some traffic and now works it across. Shot from the opposite side by Ouellette is hammered wide. Shoveled out of the zone by Henrique. Quickly back into the zone, Nyquist, but knocked off his stick by the other 14, and now Henrique darting back the other way. Here's Henrique, hit by Franzen, still holding the puck. Henrique gets a shot away, and it's stopped by Jimmy Howard and cleared back to the point. Neat little maneuver by Zdlitsky to hold the zone. Taken here by Jelena, and his shot is blocked.
Henrique with a great chance. I don't know how Howard saw it. And what a move by Zdlitsky, and have the courage and guts to make that play on Drew Miller. He doesn't get by him, and Miller might be off to on a breakaway.
Played behind the net, and Zdlitsky slices it across to the stick of Jordan Tutu. Here's Weiss working it across. Red Wings gain the zone again. Oh, but offside as the call is inspired into Schneider's glove.
Here's the chance I'm talking about, Steve. Adam Henrique, real good strength there. Position on Franzen, and gets a puck, and he gets a quick shot off. I don't know if it just hit Howard because it was hard to see. And there's the move I was talking about, Marek Zdlitsky. I don't think coaches want to see that all the time. The little dipsy doodle through the puck through the legs of Miller at the point.
Can take control by the wings. Weiss had it knocked off his stick. Quincy at the point sends it towards goal, but it's blocked away by Adam Larson. 1-1 game, opening minutes of the third period. Green trying to nurse the puck away from Drew Miller, but it's taken by Weiss. Weiss looks to send it towards goal, but it's deflected out of play. Let's see where the faceoff is. It will stay in the Devil's zone.
Mike Camilleri has really taken on a leadership role here in New Jersey, Steve, and his last goal was December 4th against the Maple Leafs. We know he was out with injury and had four shots last game, but they're going to rely on this guy. I mean, he's been a real nice signing the offseason. He just needs to stay healthy, and I think it's right there where he'll score goals. We know Devils need some big goals, and he's a guy that doesn't need as many chances. It's coming. You don't just come back in the lineup after missing periods of time and have your timing completely. But he had four shots, I mentioned last game, so I expect him to start scoring soon.
11 on the season. Still good for the team lead as it's worked across here. DeKaiser gives it up. Yurko got a shot away, but that was blocked away and deflected away to the stick of Tatar. Kicked at by New Jersey and Green and picked up here by Sislo. Here's Sislo trying to get into the Detroit end. He's defended well, and now Sheahan darts back the other way. Here's Riley Sheahan, goes wide on Zdlitsky. Tries to backhand one in front, no can do, and it's picked up by Sislo. John Merrill ahead, and the Devils skated away. Sislo will dump in. Full change for the Devils here as it's played back by Nicholas Cronwall.
Notice the Detroit Red Wings, when they gain the offensive zone and they got speed, they go around the net. They really like that backhand pass coming back the other for the backdoor play. Very set play with a lot of the players on this Red Wing team, and that's because they can handle a puck and have the skill to make that play.
They really go four lines deep, this group. Here's Zetterberg, big part of that. Taken here at the circle. Zetterberg tries to work it across for the cutting. Pavel Datsyuk, but the Devils able to work it away. Played back into the Detroit end, controlled by Cronwall. Gets it back from Datsyuk, and now the Red Wings break out with Zetterberg on the puck. Waiting for it, Abdelkader. He's over the line. Return pass for Justin Abdelkader. Walks in and shoots, and that's a pad save by Schneider. Skated away by Ruutu. They look for Bernier on the opposite side. Defended away, and Ouellette tries to deflect it out of the zone. Worked across and controlled here by Helm. Darren Helm shoots. Schneider with the save. Franzen following up on the far side. Here's Johan Franzen, hit by Green and sent down to the ice. Red Wings stay with it, though. Centering try punched away by Harold and taken by Ruutu.
You just sense here the Red Wings have turned it up a notch. Devils are going to have to get pucks deep and spend time in Detroit's end, because when they get in the offensive end, they can do some things. But you feel that after their performance against the Bruins, which wasn't good, Coach Babcock not happy with it. They're going to turn it up here in the third. You're seeing that now.
Collected here by the Red Wings. Helm able to settle it down and control for Detroit. Sestito, Whitney, 2-2 on here for the Devils. Line that's created a goal here tonight as it's played to Steven Weiss. Over the line, Camilleri there to deal with him. So's Adam Larson. When the Red Wings have Weiss in the lineup, they're 9-2-2 this season. Problem has been keeping him on the ice. Groin injury and then a shoulder injury getting in the way.
That's some of the depth you're talking about, this Red Wing team. Steven Weiss is playing on the fourth line right now with Glendening and Miller. That's a pretty talented fourth line.
Fourth overall pick in the draft by Florida. Taken away by the Devils. Centering try by Camilleri. Never got through. DeKaiser. Knocked down to the ice. Tries to work it ahead and does. And now the Red Wings able to break out as it's dumped back in. Glendening sends it into the Devils' end. Miller plays it ahead. And now Zajac lifts it back into the Detroit end. Does it have enough for an icing call? The officials say yes, it does. Mention Glendening. What's it like for a kid from Grand Rapids, Michigan to put a Red Wings jersey on at work? Glendening was saying today, every day is a dream come true. He grew up about a two-hour drive from this arena. His favorite player wore 19. I said, give me something other than the obvious, Steve Yzerman. And he said, you don't understand. If you're a young kid growing up in these parts, you can't see past the prism of Steve Yzerman. I guess I understand that.
Yeah, the longtime captain, now general manager of the Tampa Bay Lightning, longtime Detroit Red Wing captain. Led them to multiple Stanley Cups. One of the greats.
Quick timeout at Joe Louis Arena. 1-1 game in Detroit.
Devils going on the power play. Right here you see Thomas Yurko get the stick in the midsection, Steve. One of these players on both teams going to learn that is a no-no. We've seen a lot of hooks tonight. And Yurko gets his stick in the midsection of John Merrill. Big time in this game for the Devils. This is where you really have to bear down. Make sure the passes are sharp. It's a 1-1 game. Next goal may win this hockey game.
Off the draw, it's won by Detroit and hammered out of the zone. Devils personnel on this key power play. Henrique, Jágr, and Bernier. Peter Harold, Marek Zadlitsky, the defenseman on. And it's played across to the stick of Jaromír Jágr. Miller interrupting his progress, and it's played back here by Zadlitsky. Marek Zadlitsky at center ice. He'll punch it in deep and give chase himself. Into the corner, puck jarred loose. Henrique trying to gobble it up. Now Bernier entering the equation too. Puck work free, and now Jágr has it and nurses it back towards the point, trying to get it to Peter Harold, and he does. Here's Henrique. Got it off the boards, and a clear here by Drew Miller.
Red Wings make it so difficult in their zone there. You see, they overloaded the side there, and Harold and Jágr and those guys had nothing, nowhere to go with it. So you got to get that puck cross ice.
Gomez will carry in this time. Tried to work it across. His pass deflected away. Glove down by Zadlitsky. And work back here to Jelena. Devils just trying to get in the zone and set something up here as Jelena takes and gives to Scott Gomez.
What I mean by cross ice, Steve, is change sides with one good pass and catch the Red Wings overloading.
Taken away here by Detroit. Here's Abdelkader in on the move. Works it across. The pass for Helm. Got by him. And now back the other way. Here come the Devils with an odd man rush. Camilleri over the line. He'll slow things down with 27 to go on the power play. They get it across to Jelena. His wrist shot gloved by Howard, who holds on.
That was an exact example I was talking about. A risky pass, albeit.
This is the game recap brought to you by our good friends at Tri-Honda Dealers. Joe Whitney with his first NHL goal. Sestito with his first point since April 10th. Darren Helm tied it on a wraparound with his first goal since December 6th. It's where we are now, 1-1.
You saw the pass, backhand pass from Mike Camilleri across over to Eric Jelinek. He had time to shoot because, again, the Red Wings overload the one side. But that was a very risky pass to Detroit Red Wings. If that's picked off, they're gone. 2-0 the other way.
Henrique steps in to take the draw. Still 23 seconds left in the hooking penalty to Thomas Yurko. Glendening wins it back. trying to hold the zone here under pressure. Sedlitsky does. Jágr trying to find the handle, but it's muscled out to center ice and taken here by John Merrill. Check that. That was Merrill at the point, and now it's taken here by Jágr. Jaromír Jágr goes wide on Eriksson, works it across. Here's Henrique shooting, and he fired it just wide.
What a chance for Adam Henrique on a great setup from Jágr, and he didn't miss by much. He knew where he wanted to shoot that puck. You can see it from here going far side, and he just misses, Steve.
Back to even strength in a 1-1 game. Under 11 minutes to go in the third. Smith leaves behind the net for Ouellette. And Yurko able to work it across. Collected here by Zetterberg. Henrik Zetterberg in. Loose at the side of the net. Trying to finish there was Datsyuk, but he couldn't pull the trigger. Sent out to center and taken again by the Red Wings. Zetterberg quickly played it ahead. It's controlled here by Adam Larsson. Taken away by Datsyuk. Datsyuk goes backhand. He's got a devil on him. Tries to work it across. Zetterberg had it knocked away from him by Sisla.
Is he ever good at pickpocketing you or anticipating where the puck's going there? He did it on Adam Larsson. Fortunately, Larsson had some help in front. The Devils have done a real good job of recovering on some of the best players in the league with Zetterberg and Datsyuk stealing pucks.
Worked across by Tatar. Loose at the side of Schneider's net and swept away again. Kicked out in the corner here by Merrill. Bouncing puck at the point. That's Quincy able to hold the zone for the Red Wings, but it comes back out again. And Bernier now trying to follow up. Gets to the loose puck. Able to drop it for Cavallari. He shoots and he fired it wide. Schneider might have gotten a piece of that to deflect it away. Better than midway through the third period now. It remains 1-1. Devils trying to put together their first winning streak in almost 6 weeks.
Well, the Kaiser almost overskated the puck. Travis Sajak did as well. He almost lost it right in the crease of Jimmy Howard.
Here's Helm in his own end. Jágr there to disrupt him, and now punched out of the zone. Got by the stick of Nyquist, icing against the Red Wings with 9:09 to play.
Here's the chance. Look at Jágr. Gained the zone. Three Red Wings go there. Nobody picks up Adam Henrique. Oh, and he did not miss by much. He knew exactly what he wanted to do. See four Red Wings over there on the right side, Steve. That's the pressure I'm talking about on the PK, leaving Henrique wide open. Jágr does a great job of recognizing that. He's such a terrific passer and pulling guys to him as well with his reach and strength. But Adam didn't miss by much. He almost broke the tie.
Nyquist works it across, and it's backhanded into the zone by Franzen. Zubras deep in his own end. Helm takes the puck for Detroit. Andy Green all over him. So was Zubras there. Puck loose along the far boards and taken here by Detroit. Franzen still battling. One knee on the ice. And collected here by Zubras in his 1,200th NHL game. With help from Jágr, gets it out to center. Over the line, the Devils have it, and Gomez will send it in deep.
I was chuckling there. That was a couple of big boys, veterans, Franz and the Mule and Jágr battling along the wall for that loose puck. I didn't know what would give there with the strength of them.
Here's Hedberg over the line. Quick shot on the one-timer by Datsyuk, and he shot it wide. Here's Datsyuk again, trying to funnel one into the corner for Abdelkader. Such a dangerous line for Detroit. Played back to the point. Smith for Datsyuk. And he'll have to retreat back to center ice. 36-year-old, two-time Stanley Cup winner Pavel Datsyuk. Played toward Schneider. Got the pad on it. And here's Zydlitsky giving to Cavallari. Works it across. 2-2. Back to Cavallari. Tries to get around his man, Ouellette. And the Frenchman would have none of it. Abdelkader back the other way. Riley Sheahan on the move here for Detroit. Tries to make his move on Schneider. Lost control of the puck. Now Sheahan still with it. Gets a shot away and fired it wide. Glove down by Sheahan again. Mike Babcock saying this morning the reason he can play Zetterberg and Datsyuk together is because Sheahan is such a good defensive center. They don't lose much on that second line. Here's Sisla back the other way. Loses control of the puck, and Sheahan back now for Detroit. Pass deflects off the stick of Tatar. And taken here by the Devils again. Racing into the zone. Henrique looking for route two. Bouncing puck. Henrique trying to find the handle. Taken away though by Detroit. Howard will stop things with Ruutu lurking in the danger area and will step aside Under 7 minutes to go in the third. It's 1-1.
Going back to the great opportunity Adam Henrique had on the power play, and there you see four Red Wings right there. This is on the power play. Clear all the penalty killers. Basically trying to cut the ice in half. Boy, they pressure. That leaves a wide open Adam Henrique. They're willing to take that chance, Steve, making you make that perfect pass. And Jaromír Jágr did exactly that. And Henrique didn't miss by much of breaking this 1-1 hockey game. But that's the pressure more than any team league. We know everybody pressures now on the penalty kill. The Red Wings are willing to say, beat us. We're going to go to you hard, make you make the play. Jaromír Jágr did just that.
Scramble in front off the ensuing faceoff is taken away by Nyquist. Dumps into the Devil's end, and Schneider leaves behind the net for Andy Green. This will be an icing call against the Devils. 6.5 to go. It's been a good one, a fun game here on New Year's Eve in Detroit.
Yeah, I feel the tension a little bit here in the crowd with 6:33 left. 1-1, it's really picked up. Both teams getting some chances. It's nerves time. Nervous time for both clubs on their bench. You don't want to make a mistake. And both teams playing a good, hard game all over the ice defensively as well.
Off the draw, taken by the Devils. Bernier has it and dumps out of the zone. Here's Xavier Ouellette back in his own end. Gives to Nyquist. Team's co-scoring leader with 15 goals. Gustav Nyquist gets a shot away, but that's deflected out of play.
Talked about Johan Franzén and the Mule having a board battle with Jaromír Jágr, and that's two big boys. You see, 7 goals, 14 assists, 21 points on the season. He's still getting it done. Been around a long time. 10 points in his last 10 games against the Devils. I think 7 of those were last year, Steve. Scored one last time these two teams met. He's always been tough on the New Jersey Devils. Hasn't had much going tonight, but the Devils have to continue to keep an eye on him. He has a knack for scoring big goals against anybody.
10th year in the National Hockey League, and of course with Detroit. Points in each win versus New Jersey this season. Off the draw, it's taken by the Devils. Camilleri gets it as far as center ice. And controlled by the Red Wings. DeKeyser has this for Detroit. Carries over the line, throws it towards goal, fought off by Schneider. Picked up by the Red Wings, and Quincy able to play it back in. Tatar with a shot, blocked away. Zajac lays it ahead and taken here by Mike Sislow for the Devils. Camilleri trying to get on the puck. Sislow comes and joins, but it's taken by DeKeyser for the Red Wings, and the rush starts the other way. Here's Justin Abdelkader over the line, just swept off his stick by the Devils. They'll use the opportunity to change here with 5.5 to go. Crowd picks it up a notch here in Detroit as Datsyuk backhands it across. It's an offside call here against the Red Wings that stops play. We'll step aside for the final time in a 1-1 game.
Tonight's goal of the game is brought to you by Nissan. Choose Nissan today for great offers on our most exciting lineup ever. Shop at ChooseNissan.com, and it's Joe Whitney recently called up from Albany with his first National Hockey League goal. And what a wicked wrist shot upstairs over the shoulder of Jimmy Howard. That is your Nissan goal of the game. And the smile told it all after that goal, Steve. Joe Whitney was one excited young man. And anytime you get your first goal and help your hockey team, that was the opening goal of the game, and we're tied at 1. You're excited.
Over the line here, trying to break the tie game is Jágr. But a stoppage here as the Devils are offside with 5:20 to go. Jaromír Jágr is being coached by one of the elite playmakers of his time. Look at what they have in common. They're each averaging, or in the case of Oates, averaged better than a point per game in their career. Adam Oates, we forget, he retired with the 5th most assists in the NHL in the league's history when he stepped away from the game. Jágr was an advocate of Pete DeBoer. He says there is something being coached by such an elite playmaker, though. Back at the point, Cronwall throws it towards goal. They scored as it deflects past Schneider. And the Red Wings take the lead late in the third.
I'll get the puck on net. Just a quick, innocent-looking wrist shot from the point. And it ends up at the back of the net. Puck goes back to Cronwall. Just a quick wrist shot. Oh, and what a deflection. As he's battling with Adam Larson, I think this is... Zetterberg gets his stick on this puck, and I have no idea how he did, but he did. Henrik Zetterberg tips this puck out of midair down past Corey Schneider to give the Red Wings a lead.
Devils trail for the first time tonight. There is a player down near the center of the ice. It's Steve Bernier. The Devils head trainer Rich Stinziano quickly off the bench to attend to number 18.
Didn't see what happened to Steve Bernier, but he is in a lot of pain. Agony lying down on the ice. Oh boy. Well, he goes to take out Brendan Smith, and I'm not sure if it's upper body, lower body, Steve. Looks like maybe his shoulder. Something along those lines. Again, you see Smith just stop up, and he missed him. And oh, man. It looks like Steve Bernier caught something's upper body. And he's down in a lot of pain.
The glass is flexible there, but that's still something where it could lead to a significant amount of pain, though, Kenny?
It just all depends on how you go in, what angle, if you're in vulnerable position, and obviously he was. It's tough to tell exactly what it is. I believe it's something with the upper body. I don't know if he twisted his knee, maybe, though. I don't know.
Slowly to his skate, Steve Bernier. He'll get some help.
Well, now that you look at it, it's not upper body. It's definitely his leg. And it's the way he went in awkwardly after Brendan Smith kind of stopped up and avoided contact there. And obviously he went into the boards, and, you know, if we take another look at it, maybe we'll see a better picture if he twisted it. I hope Steve's okay. Boy, has he played hard for this Devils team. And if he twisted it too much, it's something I can't watch. Those are things I don't like to watch if it bent in a position it's not supposed to. We'll see again. Let's take a look. Bernier goes to the puck. Oh, it is so hard to tell. Looks like he banged the top of his knee.
Yeah.
With a lot of velocity into the boards. There was no twist or anything like that, Steve, but just went in an awkward position, and let's hope Steve Bernier is okay. But he was hurting at the time.
As they tend to Steve Bernier, the faceoff in the Devil's zone after the icing call taken here, and the quick shot stopped by Schneider off the shot from Smith at the point. Back come the Devils, collected here by Henrique and knocked off his stick. Jelinek sends it towards goal. Right behind Dina Zubras, who never saw the puck. Devils now trying to get the game tied. Helm ties up Zydlitzky. Here's Darren Helm trying to get around Jelinek. There's a penalty coming up, but he scores! Darren Helm, second of the game.
This is some kind of effort by Darren Helm. Red Wings take a 3-1 lead on a very hard-working, second-effort type of goal. Darren Helm, great wheels, shows the speed, getting wrapped up by Jelena. There was a delayed call on the play, and he's able to go there. See how he shields the puck, Steve, so well. And able to get it to his forehand. Again, you look here, shields the puck. Somehow gets it on his forehand, able to beat Corey Schneider. That's just a great individual effort by Darren Helm. Devils pressing a little bit, get caught. Eric Jelena thought he did enough to even take a penalty, at least not give him that kind of chance, but Helm stuck with it and showed his speed. Beautiful goal by Darren Helm. And the Devils all of a sudden down 3-1.
Just recently announced the second goal. Zetterberg, his ninth of the year. Helm with his sixth and seventh goals of the season. And the Red Wings now lead 3-1, just over 4 minutes to go. Cronwall and Datsyuk get the assists on the Zetterberg goal, the go-ahead goal for Detroit. carried here by Adam Larson and worked to center. Batted out of midair by Zajac. Giving chase here is Sisla. Comes in front. Zajac sent it back to a point, but Andy Green heading the wrong way. And now Green back in his own end.
Now going back to Darren Helm's goal. Boy, players in the National Hockey League these days, not just Darren Helm, but a lot of them, so strong, and the balance they display with players basically on their back. And for him to get that on his forehand and get a lot on it to put it past Schneider, it really is remarkable how the balance these guys have and the speed and using their edges as well for their blades and staying on their feet.
Gomez tried to get around Erickson, couldn't do it, and now Miller has it at center ice. Banks it off the boards. It's picked up here by Datsyuk. Pavel Datsyuk plays it across. Tatar with a shot, and the backhander is gobbled up by Corey Schneider.
Red Wings smelling blood. They're a team that once they get on track, they're going to continue to press you, and we've seen a lot of chances. And it all started originally, the go-ahead goal, the second goal by Zetterberg. An innocent-looking shot. Wings were just getting pucks to the net because Devils doing such a good job in front of Schneider. Red Wings didn't have much to shoot at, but all of a sudden now it's opened up a little bit because the Devils have to take some chances being behind now.
Off the faceoff, controlled by Detroit. Nyquist into the corner for Franzen. Here's Johan Franzen on the puck. Continues to hold. Henrique. All over him, and now Merrill collides with Helm. Darren Helm in the corner. Looking for number three is 43 in red. Collected by Detroit. Here's Franzen again, who whisks it behind the net, and Helm is waiting there. Where the Red Wings prefer to keep the game with the 3-1 lead. Helm. Bumped by Merrill, and now Nyquist behind the net. Precious time ticking away for the Devils. They need two to tie. There's another penalty coming up, is there? Indeed, there is. Howard made his way to the bench, and that might be the Devils' final undoing. It's against New Jersey.
Now the Red Wings making it so difficult to get the puck from them, protecting it, and there's Nyquist. We saw in the pregame him score that highlight reel goal against Ottawa, having the puck for so long. I mean, he's got guys draped all over him. Look how he protects that puck. You know, he's not a real big guy, and that is a lot of strength as well. But Adam Henrique ends up taking a penalty there. And it's been, since the Red Wings scored that second goal, they've really started to turn it on a notch.
On Nyquist, it was Pavel Datsyuk who said this week, he's a really fun player to watch. That's like Picasso saying, I like your painting. Who's more fun than Datsyuk? Collected here by Detroit, guided back. Cronwall plays it across. That shot stopped by Schneider. Loose puck picked up here by the Devils and skated back the other way. It's Zajac over the line. Here's Travis shooting, and that's blocked. Zajac again, and it's blocked away again. Cronwall able to deny Zajac twice.
Well, Cronwall playing backboard there, blocking two Zajac shots shorthanded.
Nyquist funnels one in front, and here's Travis tracking this down. 1:40 to go in period three. It's a Red Wings power play, and Detroit's got the lead. Erickson works it down low. Here's DeKaiser playing it back to the corner. Sheahan bumped behind the net. Tatar. Zajac there to deal with him. See how content the Red Wings are just to keep possession of the puck here in the waning moments. They come out with it. Played down low. Nyquist holds, guides it back to the point. Erickson for DeKaiser. Looks at the net, plays it to the side, taken away by the Devils, and now without a stick is Adam Larson as the Devils clear it away. Under a minute to go, though. Fans sensing the celebration on this New Year's Eve here in Detroit as Zetterberg motors into the Devils' end. Taken here by Datsyuk. His pass hops over the stick of Cronwall. Red Wings will answer the call after losing to Boston on Monday night. Helm has the puck here. Coach Mike Babcock not pleased at all with the effort Monday. They rally here. The Devils scored first on the Joe Whitney goal. The next three unanswered by Detroit as Schneider has to get rid of that. 15 seconds to go. Devils will head into 2015 with a record of 13-19-7. 11 points out of a playoff berth. On their feet at Joe Louis Arena, the Red Wings defeat the Devils 3-1. Jimmy Howard, 12 saves tonight in the victory. We're back on the Devils postgame show in just a few moments. Coming home for the Canadians on Friday night. The postgame, moments away.